The video that we sent, Bob, is the Dodgers forfeit to the Cardinals, and it was an ESPN clip. You standing up for your partner. He writes, "You standing up for your partner behind the plate by banging the game with your hat is one of my favorite all-time umpiring moments. Would have loved to have you as a crewmate out on the field." This was a crazy game. With a couple ejections and then a forfeit, which is not something that you wanted to do, but it was necessary. Take us through it.
Well, you know, actually, that was not my decision. Jim Quick, who was the plate umpire that night, and Billy Hahn, Larry Poncino were the other guys on the field that day, that night at Dodger Stadium. And Tommy Lasorda and I we couldn't see eye to eye on anything, on nothing. And I've thrown him out, I don't know, four or five times. And Quickie had to play it, and he threw out Eric Karros, he threw out Mondesi, Raul Mondesi, and then he threw out Tommy. And so the baseballs, there was a base, they'd never had this since, a giveaway baseballs before the game. That pretty much stopped it, but they gave away these baseballs that had the Dodger Rookie of the Years on it. And they had a big crowd. I mean, they had pretty close to 40,000, if not over. And about the seventh inning, after Quick threw out Lasorda, here come the baseballs from all over. And they just, you know, landed in the I mean, there had to be, I want to say, 15,000 baseballs the first time that they threw on the field. So Quickie got everybody off the field, and the Cardinals were on and got them off. And I remember Mike Jorgensen was the interim manager of the Cardinals for this at this time. I think he was the interim between Joe Torre and Tony La Russa. So Jorgensen was going to finish out that year as the Cardinal manager, and Jorgensen come out and say, "Hey, they can't do that." And I said, "Really?" So we got all the players off the field, and it probably took, I want to say, 15 minutes for the ground crew to clean up all these baseballs. Sure. And Lasorda came out, and you know, and he's all huffing and puffing, and Quickie's telling him, "Hey, you know, you can't throw baseballs on the field. You know, if this happens again, we're gonna forfeit the game." "Oh, you guys aren't gonna do that." And so Quickie says, "Get out, Tommy, go. I mean, we're gonna resume after the balls are picked up." So we got, after about 15 minutes, all the baseballs are picked up, and we get to an inning or so later, and a bunch of baseballs came again in the outfield. And, you know, we stopped time, but, you know, we let the ground crew pick those up. That might have been just a couple hundred that time. So now we're in the top of the, it's the bottom of the ninth. And the Cardinals were up 2-1, I remember. And all of a sudden, the baseballs came at Ricky Jordan, the football player also. I think it's Rip. No, it's
Brian Jordan.
Brian Jordan. That's right. Thank you. Brian Jordan. He's playing center field. And all of a sudden, baseballs, they just came hurtling at him. And then now the baseballs are coming again. And this is the third time. And Quickie said to me, he said, "You know, Bob, go ahead and whack it. Let's get out of here." So it was Quickie's call as the crew chief, and it was the correct one. And then I waved it off, and why Quickie didn't want to wave it off, I don't know. But, you know, it was all on him as the chief, you know, and he had a lot going on, and he just wanted to get out of there and try to sort it out. So anyway, we forfeited the game, and we made the proper, I mean, it's just something that had to be done, unfortunately. And so I'll never forget, we were staying in Pasadena, and it was the last game of the series, and Quickie said, "Come on with me. We got to call Lynn." Coleman was the league president. "We got to call Lynn." I said, "Okay." And so I went in his room, and I got on the other phone. Quickie was on another phone, and he calls Leonard's house, and Leonard's asleep. He goes, "Oh," and Quickie says, "Mr. Coleman, Jim Quick and Bob Davidson here. We had a forfeit the game here at Dodger Stadium." and you must have done a sub. What? You went nuts. You guys did what? And I said, yeah, we, Quick said, yeah, we had a forfeit. I mean, we gave them three chances. They gave away, you know, 45,000 baseballs before the game. And, not one fan has a ball now. They were all on the field. And then Leonard settled down and he said, okay, well, get your report. I'll be talking to you tomorrow. And so,
oh boy.
And so that was that. And I'll never forget the next day. We were at Candlestick Park and we came on the field from, the right field corner, and we're coming on the field and the Giants, they kind of gave us a standing ovation. The players did for what we did. They thought it was, cause anytime the Dodgers lost, I guess the Giants were happy. It was a funny deal about that, but that's the story of that one.